happening now in the newsroom.
We're chasing our tails as a nation when it comes to the Russians.
The cloud of Russia hanging over the White House grows with allegations about the president's son-in-law, Jared Kushner.
I can't confirm or deny whether they're accurate, but if they are, it's obviously very concerning.
I know Jared. He's a great guy, decent guy. A lot of different ways to communicate back channel, you know, publicly with other countries. I don't see any big issue here.
I think Jared has said that he's more than willing to answer any and all questions.
My dashboard warning light was clearly on, and I think that was the case with all of us in the intelligence community, very concerned about the nature of these approaches to the Russians.
CNN Newsroom starts now. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm Frederica Whitfield. The president is back at the White House after his first trip overseas, strategizing now on how to quell the steady stream of leaks on the Russia investigation that have dominated the week's headlines. A senior administration official tells CNN today is a working day in the West Wing, adding President Trump is likely to meet with his legal team and aides. And just moments after arriving back at the White House last night, the president was immediately confronted with new reports about son-in-law and senior advisor Jared Kushner.
Mr. President, is Jared trying to set up a back channel to the Russians?
All right, let's go to CNN Washington correspondent Ryan Noble. So, Ryan, so far, the administration has refused to comment about the reports of a proposed secret communication line to the Kremlin. Are we hearing anything today now?
We're getting some conversation from some of the members of the Trump administration, Frederica, but no one has specifically confirmed or denied this report that Jared Kushner was seeking up this secret back channel line of communication with the Russian government and the transition team. We do know that H.R. McMaster, the national security advisor, defended the concept kind of broadly without specifically talking about Kushner. And we heard the same this morning from the director of Homeland Security, John Kelly. He was on NBC and pressed by Chuck Todd on this particular issue, and this is how Kelly responded.
I know Jared. He's a great guy, decent guy. His number one interest really is the nation. So you know, there's a lot of different ways to communicate back channel, you know, publicly with other countries. I don't see any big issue here relative to Jared.
Even with an adversary, somebody that was at the time, mm-hmm. Our own intelligence community had collectively said this was a country that had infiltrated our election. Did this show good judgment?
Well, you know, it's before the government was in place during the transition period, I think, from what I understand, and I think any time you can open lines of communication with anyone, whether they're good friends or not so good friends, is a smart thing to do.
It's important to point out that we still don't know the specific details of this interaction that was allegedly attempted to be set up by Jared Kushner. The reports have come from intelligence sources that learned that the ambassador, Sergei Kislyak, informed his superiors about this attempt by Kushner to do so. And the White House has not provided any specifics about it. And as I said before, has yet to confirm or deny. Meanwhile, the president, as you mentioned, Frederica, is here at the White House today. They're calling this a working day. He's huddling with his advisors and perhaps his legal team as he continues to confront this ocean of controversy related to Russia's attempt to intervene in the U.S. election and his campaign's perhaps ties to that. We're not sure if the president will be on the move at all today, but if he is, Frederica will be certain to update you.
All right. I know you will. Thanks so much, Ryan Nobles. Appreciate it. All right. A lot to talk about here. So let's bring in our panel, James Gagliano, CNN law enforcement analyst, and Patrick Healy, CNN political analyst. Good to see both of you gentlemen. All right. So, James, you first. We heard from Secretary John Kelly. Now I want to play some sound from former director of national intelligence, James Clapper. And here he is reacting to the story on Kushner's back channel discussion that's been reported with the Russian ambassador.
I have to say that without specific, specifically affirming or confirming these conversations, since even though they're in the public realm, they're still classified. But just from a theoretical standpoint, I will tell you that My dashboard warning light was clearly on, and I think that was the case with all of us in the intelligence community, very concerned about the nature of these approaches to the Russians.
All right, so James Clapper is very concerned. How concerned should those within the intel community be at this point?
Sure, Frederica. I've definitely tried to apply equanimity to this situation of looking at the actions of the current president. I was fiercely critical of how he treated the former FBI director. But I also want to caution you as we go forward. I think it's important for your audience to understand we can't open investigations and then go in search of a crime from the FBI. We have to see evidence of a crime. Is it unsettling to me that Jared Kushner is part of the president's transition team elected to try to have a meeting on what is Russian soil? Remember, a U.S. embassy overseas is U.S. soil, and the Russian embassy here is Russian soil. Is that unsettling? Absolutely. Are the optics bad? Absolutely. But again, as bad as it may look, the appearance of impropriety, I still think we have to put everything into context and make sure that we don't automatically jump to the conclusion that a crime is concluded.
Well, what do you mean the context? Because what, I mean, if Jared Kushner or anybody else involved the Pentagon with this plan, even as transition, perhaps you and others in the intel community would be less unsettled. But as of right now, based on the kind of reporting that's at hand, it's not clear whether anyone within the Obama administration, because this was during transition, anyone within the intel community was privy to this proposed plan.
Sure, and I think we all understand the need for there to be one president at a time. And even if you have a lame duck president, as the 44th president was at the time, he's still the president. But it's not unprecedented that transition teams, this has been discussed from the National Security Advisor now, H.R. McMaster, as other folks as well. This is a normal course of business for a transition team.
Does it reach out to another country?
Yes. Now, does it appear unseemly because they look to do it on Russian soil, which is the embassy here in the United States? Yes. But again, no crime. I mean, we have the Logan Act in place, which precludes U.S. citizens from reaching out and doing the business of our government. Mm-hmm. But again, since 1799, I can't think of one instance where somebody has been prosecuted for that.
Okay.